Recently, someone asked, is the filter order in On1 Photo important? Let's find out. What I want to do today is show you the test to say whether or not that order is really important. On screen at the moment, you can see the test image. We're going to start by duplicating the image onto two separate layers. We're then going to select one of these layers and we're going to apply some of the edits to it in On1. Now I'm using On1 Photo Effects RAW 2019 and we're going to apply some of the filters that I typically believe cause problems if you don't get them in the right order. We're going to start with a test between contrast adjustment using the tone enhancer and also the color adjustment and saturation. My own personal rule is to do any tone enhancements prior to colour enhancements. And the reason for this is because saturation gets affected when you adjust the contrast in the image. Now I'm going to apply very strong adjustments here so we can check quite easily the difference. And immediately, just from the curves adjustment there, you can see that we've really boosted the contrast and the saturation in the image. Now let's apply one of the preset adjustments in the color enhancer. And that again has made the image very extreme. I'm now going to save this back to the layer. Now you can't see it at the moment because there's another layer on top of it, so we'll just check it has worked. As you can see it has. We'll now take the second layer and we'll apply the same adjustment, but we'll switch the order of the filters. On1 has picked up the same adjustments that we had previously, so we'll take this tone enhancer and we'll now drop it at the top of the filter stack. Let's see if that's made any difference. Now that we've got both layers adjusted, all we can do is hide the top layer and we should be able to see if there's any difference. And from that, I can see that there is. Watch this area of the rock here when I turn off the top layer. So with the top layer, what we had was the tone enhancement after the colour adjustment. So by switching the filters around in that way, what you can see is that the area here is brighter and more saturated. And you can also see it in the histogram up here when I turn the layer off. Let's now try another. I'll delete the layers first and create two more test layers. And then we'll go back into On1. And let's reset all the adjustments. Next, I want to test two of the other filters. I've always applied a tone adjustment before the glow adjustment. Let's start by enhancing the tones. And I'm going to use a detail enhancement and a clarity enhancement on this, and I'm going to add a little bit of contrast. And a curves adjustment. Now the reason that I've always added the tone enhancer first is that the glow effect should counteract the sharpening effect or the detail enhancement in the image. I'm going to use the strong soft light. Again, because we want an extreme example. So here we can see the details being enhanced by the tone enhancer, and the glow enhancer is then being used to add a glowing effect over that. So let's apply that. We'll check our layer worked, and now we'll repeat it with our other test layer. Let's swap round the glow and the tone enhancer. And now let's check if the change in order has had any effect on the result. Again, there is some effect if you watch the pebbles down here when I turn off the top layer. So the detail enhancement in the tone adjustment has actually affected the glow layer when it was below it, but again, it's marginal. Let's check the histogram. And you can see very little adjustment has taken place in the histogram. The impact of this is not quite as large as you might have thought. Let's get rid of these layers and let's do another test, but this time we're going to check dynamic contrast and glow. I'm going to delete our tone adjustment and we'll leave the glow in place. I'll add the dynamic contrast. I'll just make sure that the glow appears on top. I've always used glow after the dynamic contrast adjustment. I'll just turn off the glow effect while I do this. I'm going to add in quite a strong adjustment. And you can see there that that's really brought out a lot of detail in the image. I'll just turn that off, it's very strong. I'll now add the glow effect. Just make that a little bit stronger. I'm now back in Photo RAW and I'm just going to switch the two layers round, or sorry, the two filters round in their order. And we'll go back and look at it in Photoshop. So on top we've got the glow effect being applied first and then the dynamic contrast, and the next layer down we've got the dynamic contrast being applied before the glow effect. So this time there is a difference. You can see in this area of the pebbles where we've got all the fine detail, much more of that detail is evident when we've applied the dynamic contrast filter after the glow effect. Let's now have a look at the next set of filters. This time we're going to look at tone and sharpening. Let's start by adding our tone adjustment. And then we'll apply a sharpening adjustment. I'll turn off the sharpening adjustment whilst we adjust the tone enhancer. And what I want to do here is use it to bring out some of the detail and clarity in the fine details of the image. I'm also going to apply some contrast adjustment to it. Again, I'm making these very strong so we can see and judge the effect. Now let's go to the sharpening adjustment. And I'll use Unsharp Mask. I'll just zoom in so you can see the effect. Very, very oversharpened, but that's the effect we want to try to judge any differences. We'll probably just reduce that halo down a little bit further, make it easier to judge. That looked good. Back to Photoshop. Let's now repeat that, but we'll switch the order. This time we'll have the sharpening before we have the tone enhancement. Let's now compare the two. Now the effect is less pronounced than I would have thought. Let's zoom in to 100% just to check the detail. So in the top layer we have the tone enhancement after the sharpening. And you can see that there's a slight difference in the way the highlights of the sharpening halo are being treated. When we've applied the sharpening first, they seem less pronounced as an effect. But having said that, they don't seem extremely different. Let's do one final test, and we'll look this time at the vignette effect. Let's reset our filters, and this time I'm going to use a preset that's already been created. And I'll go for probably this sunshine filter. Now that's very, very strong, but that's exactly what we want to see. And we'll just reduce it a little bit in terms of the overall opacity. My rule of thumb is that I always apply the vignette effect last, because the adjustments that we make can actually affect the vignette in terms of its darkness. let's now start by adding a vignette to the top of the layers. And we'll use the big softy effect. And immediately you can see the effect of the vignette. Let's add that now. And we'll go back to Photoshop. I'm now working on the second layer from Photoshop, and this time let's move the vignette down in the stack of filters. We now have our vignette on the very bottom of all the filters. Let's apply that and check the results in Photoshop. The top layer has the vignette applied at the bottom or the first filter, and as you can see, it's quite dark. Let's now check it where we had it applied on the top layer. As you can see, the effect is more pronounced when we've put the vignette at the bottom of all the filters. So what do we make of all this? What we've seen is that there is a difference when you move the order of the filters, but, and this is the big but, when you're just editing, actually, it doesn't seem to matter about the order. It's only when you apply extremely strong effects and then move the order of the filter that you see the result change. And let's be honest, the results have been quite minor. Now, if I had taken this last example where we had the vignette effect first, had I applied subsequent adjustments, I would probably have made different choices about how I would have used each of those adjustment filters. And I would have probably still ended up with an image that looked good at the end of it. In none of these tests am I seeing anything that says this is ruining the image. So in upshot, I was wrong. I don't actually believe that the filter order is important. What is important is to get the image looking right, but then don't change the order of the filters. When you change the order, that's when things start to look different. I've certainly found this enlightening. I hope you've enjoyed it. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next week for another video.